Hi, I want to do a quick video on the other book that I had read as part of the Bangalore Book Club. The book is called Widows of Malabar Hill. It's by this author, Sujata Massey. And it's a thriller, it's a whodunit. And it's not too much of a thriller, actually, or rather it's not paced as a thriller. The premise is very interesting though. It is set in 1920s Bombay. And a very rich Muslim gentleman has passed away, and his will is being attended to by a law firm in which a lady called Parveen Mistry works, and she is the very first female advocate in the country. But she has a backstory which involves her dropping out of law school because of the kind of bullying she faces, her falling in love with someone and moving to Calcutta after marriage, etc. And there is a whole lot we learn about Bombay at the time, the role of the Britishers in the city, on how they went about maintaining law and order, or rather insisting that law and order be maintained according to their standards, or insisting on preferential treatment. And it's about the Parsi community. And when I say it's about the Parsi community, obviously the protagonist is a Parsi lady. She's the first woman advocate. Actually, she's not an advocate. She's a solicitor. She can't appear in court, but she has passed her law exams. She's waiting for enrollment. From what I understand, this particular book is part of a series that the author will write. Okay, so that's about the plot or the premise of the book. So the plot exactly is this. There's a man, he has passed away. He was very old. He's got three wives, and he has a caretaker, and the caretaker is insisting that that a part of the mansion in which the man lived that be given to the waqf, which is kind of a part of income that is spent on charity or something that attends to societal needs. So that's the deal. And the lady, Parveen Mistry, she gets involved, and she is a little suspicious about the role of the three wives. You know, she feels that this caretaker is taking them for a ride, and that the women who, again, to these women, these wives who are now widows, they live in this huge house in Malabar Hill, which, if you're familiar with Bombay, it's a very, very rich, posh area. So they live there, and their house is on prime real estate, and they live in Parda. So they have not had any contact with the outside world for a really long time. It's a very interesting plot. And then the caretaker is killed, and now who has killed the caretaker and why, and so on and so forth. And then there is the backstory of the lawyer also that has to basically unfold. So, you know, and this is a funny way to basically review the book, but on paper this seems really interesting, but as a read it was not very exciting, you know. And I love Bombay, I love reading about Parsis, and I love a good whodunit, and you know, all three of these components, which is Bombay, and especially Bombay in the British era, pre-independence, and the Parsi community, and whodunit, all of these invite a lot of you know, if you're not careful, you can really parody these components, and you can really make all of these a cliche, which unfortunately I feel this book has become. Although there is a lot of meticulous research that's gone into the book, in fact, the way she explains the Parsi eateries or the day-to-day menu in Parveen's household, in the mystery household, all that is exciting, you know. And even the landscaping of Bombay, which, you know, if you're a Bombayite, you will really like it, because if you have always lived in Bombay, then you really like the Colaba area and Malabar Hill and Nepenthe Road, and not really much has changed since then. The power dynamics and that's where the rich people live, where the haves have always inhabited, all of that. So that is interesting. But you know, here's the thing, it's like the writer did a lot of research, and you can see it, which maybe is not the best thing in a piece of fiction. It does not blend into the narrative too well. It really feels like a really, really interesting Wikipedia page. But other than that, I mean, if you are looking for an interesting read, or just something which has a different protagonist, you know, a female lawyer, a Parsi lawyer, and the very first female advocate, barrister, solicitor, sorry, I'm getting jumbled with the terms, female solicitor in the country, then I suppose it's nice. Or else, you know, you might like it if you've not read a lot of books on Bombay. So for example, if you've not read Rohinton Mystery or Salman Rushdie or Kiran Nagarkar, then it's a good book to read. But if you've read the others, then you kind of know that these themes have been handled by others and much better. So yeah, thank you.